In this episode of Man 101, we're talking about the two main goals I believe that every man should have. We're more interested in practical advice for 21st century manhood than platitudes that are hard to implement. The two main goals we are discussing today are 1, becoming the servant prince you were created to be, and 2, becoming a capable shepherd, willing and able to care for the needs of others. Every man was created to be a king, but the tyrant kings, fallen angels that the Bible also calls spirits of Antichrist, use this language to emphasize a lordship over other people. Language like alpha males, high body counts, red pill, and so on. Here, we emphasize that in creation, mankind is given to ruler over the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea. But we were not created to rule. We were not created to rule or exert authority over other men or over women beyond our wife.
At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. At the name of Jesus, every tongue confess.
When we come under the lordship of Jesus Christ, who is the King of Kings, we gain a measure of authority for his great commission of following him and teaching others to do the same. But if we state our goal as to become a king, there is too much temptation to seize authority with various fleshly tricks and the help of the dark angels. So instead, we state the goal of every man as to become the servant prince you were created to be. My hope is that by thinking of ourselves as servant princes, we can walk in humble fear of our Father in heaven, who is our King. Our service as princes needs to be modeled after Jesus, who laid down his life for his friends. Ask not what your tribe can do for you. Seek how to be a better servant to your tribe. The main emphasis on princely service is being generous givers rather than takers. For most young men, the emphasis here will be on learning to work hard to earn our daily bread with a sufficient overflow to provide care for others beyond ourselves. Further, our service to others must be with an open hand, without expecting undue loyalty, allegiance, sexual favors, or service in return. Our hope is that those we serve will learn from our example to serve Jesus as their King and to serve others as they walk better in their princely roles. The eyes and heart of a shepherd considers the needs of others as more important than his own. The shepherd is looking and listening for needs. He listens and watches more than he talks and advises. He longs to see others protected, others growing, and others well fed. The shepherd's leadership is more geared to motivate than to compel. And when compelling is necessary, the shepherd trusts God's word and God's answer to his prayers more than his own efforts at compelling. Shepherds recognize and oppose the work of wolves who often seek sexual or financial advantage. Seeking that sexual or financial advantage is often the distinction between the sheep, the shepherd, and the wolf. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the great privilege of being men. Help us to be the men you created us to be. Help us to be men like Jesus. We thank you for the Lord Jesus and for his precious blood that was spilled on our behalf. Lord God, help us to come out from under the tyrant kings. Help us to come out from under the spirits of Antichrist. Help us to crucify our flesh, Lord God, that wants to be served, that wants to be first, so that we can serve our fellow men as the princes and as the shepherds. Lord God, teach us to open our eyes and open our ears and to look and to listen for the needs of those around us. Give us the gift of prophecy, Lord God, so that we can grasp by your Holy Spirit things that we don't have the natural capacity to see, to hear, and sometimes even to understand. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Now Jesus from the mountains, and Jesus in the street, Jesus in the darkness over every enemy, Jesus for my family, I speak the holy name.
There's a long black train coming down the line.
Hey man, how's it going?
I've messed everything up. Flunked out of school, my girl dumped me. No one wants to hire me because the drug thing.
Feeding off the souls that are lost and crying.
You ask Jesus for help?
What's the point? Maybe it's time to unburden everyone from my crap.
A year ago, I was like a deer in the headlights. Whenever I wondered if a friend was contemplating suicide, my ministry training had not prepared me to handle these crisis encounters. Then I took a suicide prevention course from E94 with Justin Pallison. This 90-minute course taught us how to recognize the warning signs, gently ask some direct questions, persuade people in crisis not to take irreversible actions, and confidently refer them to one of the free and widely available resources to move them from crisis to lasting recovery. Justin is a qualified, gifted, and skilled teacher. He's the right man at the right time to bring this training to you and your church. This training is free and can be provided in person in North Georgia, and virtual training is available anywhere in the world. Visit their website at e94.org for more information.
Cling to the Father.